Good morning, all the respected dignitaries and delegates. I am Namrata Sehrawat, and I'm going to be your host for the day. Well, I'm just here to ease your curiosity. We are waiting for LG sir to join. So we'll be resuming our session of the day in another 5 minutes. So I request all of you to kindly check your audio and video. Till then, let's have a break for another 5 to 10 minutes, and we'll be starting our inaugural session very soon.
So good morning, Dr. Verma. Dr. Verma, can you hear me? Hello. Tej Pratap sir, are you there? Hello. Ramaji, I don't understand. Are you able to hear me? Okay. So I was wondering whether people are hearing. Dr. Verma, are you able to hear me? Namrata, you can, I think, start at, in 1 minute. Honorable LG sir has come.
Good morning, one and all. On behalf of Association of Indian Universities and Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, I, Namrata Sehrawat, take immense pleasure and honor in welcoming all the distinguished guests and delegates to North Zone Vice Chancellors Meet 2021. I would like to extend a very warm welcome to our Honorable Chief Guest, Shri Anil Baijal, Honorable Lieutenant Governor, Delhi, Dr. Tej Pratap, Honorable President, AIU, and Vice Chancellor, G.B. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Honorable Secretary General, AIU, Shri H. Rajesh Prasad, Principal Secretary in Education Department of Government of Delhi, Professor Mahesh Verma, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, and Sri Ravi Dadij, Registrar Gurgobind Singh Indraprastha University, and all the distinguished Vice Chancellors of the North Zone Universities. The theme of today's conference is Strategies for Implementing National Education Policy 2020, with holistic and multidisciplinary education along with technology integration. Well, it is indeed a remarkable day as all the revered minds of the education sector have come together to connect and exchange ideas on the future prospects of India transforming into a vibrant knowledge society through strategically implementing the recently launched National Education Policy 2020, which aims at the development of holistic and multidisciplinary education. To mark the beginning of this session, we will have our traditional auspicious lamp lighting ceremony as a tribute to Ma Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge. I would request the Honorable Chief Guest, Sri Anil Baijal, Honorable Lieutenant Governor Delhi, to inaugurate the meet by lighting the auspice lamp. I request Dr. Tej Pratap, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Sri H. Rajesh Prasad, Professor Mahesh Verma, and Sri Ravi Dadij to kindly join for the same.
Kurutvam kalyanam arogyam dhana sampada shubham kurutvam kalyanam arogyam dhana sampada shatru buddhi vinashaya deepajyotir namostute deepajyotir namostute shubham kurutvam kalyanam arogyam dhana sampada shubham kurutvam kalyanam arogyam dhana sampada.
Thank you so much, Honorable Lieutenant Governor Delhi, to ignite the auspice lamp. And thank you others for joining. May I now request Padma Shri, Professor Dr. Mahesh Verma, Vice Chancellor, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, to deliver his welcome address.
I think you're on mute, Professor Verma. We are not able to hear you.
Doc, you're not audible.
We are checking the audio in VC Sir's system. Please allow us a few minutes.
Thank you.
बोलना सर को.
हेलो
यस
एम आई ऑडिबल सर नाउ.
यस लेट हिम स्पीक.
एम आई ऑडिबल सर नाउ.
यस यस यस
यस सर यू आर ऑडिबल.
यस यू आर ऑडिबल प्लीज.
थैंक यू सर. चीफ गेस्ट रिस्पेक्टेड श्री आनंद बैजल ऑनरेबल लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर दिल्ली एंड चांसलर गुरु गोविंद सिंह इंद्रप्रस्थ यूनिवर्सिटी डॉक्टर तेज प्रताप President Association of Indian Universities and Vice Chancellor G.P. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar, Shri H. Rajesh Prasad, Principal Secretary Higher Education, Government of NCT of Delhi, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General AIU, Shri Ravi Dagich, Registrar, all the distinguished Vice Chancellors, keynote speakers, leadership of APEX bodies, professors and faculty members. It's a matter of sheer pride. An immense privilege for me to be witnessing the launch of this stupendous event. At the outset, I welcome our distinguished chief guest, Shri Anil Bajal, Honorable Lieutenant Governor, Delhi, for sparing his valuable time to be in our midst. Thank you, Honorable Sir, for gracing the occasion. We are also blessed to have your continued guidance, support, and encouragement at Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. We are extremely fortunate that Indraprastha University has been chosen to conduct this unique virtual meet. I am thankful to guest of honor, Dr. Tej Pratap, President, and Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General AIU, for their consent and support in organizing and arranging this meet. We are extremely delighted for their valued presence here. Our Principal Secretary Higher Education, Mr. H. Rajesh Prasad IAS, is a dynamic officer who is committed to support and implement the innumerable tenets of national education policy, along with helping us to transform and upgrade the entire structure of Indian higher education in Delhi. Thank you, sir, for being with us this morning. There could not have been any better theme for this meet than holistic and multidisciplinary education with technology integration. Educational institutions all over the world are poised to explore opportunities that are found at the intersection of established mainstream disciplines. And technology is the tool to identify these emerging areas. The current world is heavily dependent on technology. Today, science and technology is witnessing a blurring of boundaries and fusion of subjects to integrate technology in almost every aspect we can think of. The North Zone AIU Zonal VCs meet this year is a great opportunity at the doorstep of NEP 2020 to create a comprehensive vision for us as a stepping stone, paving the way to the future of Indian higher education. Even though this confluence of minds is being facilitated by the virtual medium, we are going to make this meet as interactive as possible. The virtual dimension has a huge role to play in the future of education, and the pandemic has only been a harbinger for this transformation. Education is about empowering students to engage with future. Higher educational institutions are learning to combine research, training, and civic engagement to foster a sustainable future. Universities have realized the need to move away from the practice of structuring disciplines as knowledge silos, but instead encourage cross-fertilization of ideas beyond specialization. For example, sustainability is a theme that cuts across disciplines, but it is shoehorned into environmental studies. Let us blend knowledge and produce meaningful engagement across disciplines that align our country better with global future. In the 4 decades of my experience as educator, I have come to understand that each individual, each student is unique. Each one of us carry our experiences within us, who we are and where we come from, shapes our journey to a very large extent. Therefore, each student, every institution has a unique set of requirements to grow and expand. The education of future would surely be personalized, and higher education institution will have to do away with one size fits all solutions. Higher education institution will have a multi institution model based on the alliance of several institutions. The curriculum will be more flexible, customized, and follow a participatory model. There is growing emphasis on lifelong education, and that will only continue to prosper. There's a huge transformation pressure on all the universities so that we can step up to the occasion and focus on providing future skills, autonomous learning, creativity, and innovation for our students. Let us discuss and debate some of these nuances and create a strong roadmap for our glorious future. I take this opportunity to thank our honorable chief guest, Shri Anil Bajaj, sir, for his gracious presence. We are looking forward to your address for the gainful insights, sir. I thank Shri H. Rajesh Prasad, Principal Secretary, Higher Education, for his honored presence and continued guidance and support for all our endeavors. Gratitude is also due to Dr. Tej Pratap, President AIU, and Dr. Pankaj Mittal for relegating us this esteemed opportunity to host this event on behalf of Association of Indian Universities. I also would like to thank all the keynote speakers, Vice Chancellors, for their wholehearted support and participation in this event. I conclude my address by quoting a very famous shloka in Sanskrit: "Harturyati na gocharam imapisham pushnati yat sarvada," which means, "Gyan adbhut dhan hai, ye aapko aisi adbhut khushi deti hai, jo kabhi samapt nahi hoti." Thank you, dhanyavad, jai hind.
Thank you so much, sir, for your very warm welcome to all the dignitaries and delegates, and for your very inspiring words. Thank you so much again. May I now request Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General, AIU, to kindly deliver her welcome and introductory address.
Thank you, Namrata. The chief guest of AIU North Zone Vice Chancellor's Conference, the Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, Shri Anil Bajalji, President of AIU, respected Dr. Tej Pratapji, Vice President of AIU, respected Professor G. Thiru Sagamji, Principal Secretary, Higher Education, Government of Delhi, Dr. H. Rajesh Prasadji, VC of Host University, IP University, that is, Professor Mahesh Parmaji, members of the Governing Council of AIU, chairpersons and speakers of various technical sessions, esteemed Vice Chancellors participating in today's conference, ladies and gentlemen, I, on behalf of myself and AIU, welcome you all to the AIU North Zone Vice Chancellors Conference on the theme Holistic and Multidisciplinary Education with Technology Integration. First of all, I would like to thank the host university, that is GGS IP University, and the Vice Chancellor, Dr. Mahesh Verma, for very kindly agreeing to host the North Zone Conference. Dr. Verma is the newly appointed VC of IP University, and this is the first time he is hosting any AIU conference. So thank you very much, Dr. Verma, for hosting the conference. I would also like to thank the Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, Shri Anil Bajalji, for sparing time to come and participate in this conference and virtually inaugurate it. Thank you very much for your kind participation, sir. As you all know, that the National Education Policy came to India. It was launched. National Education Policy was launched after 34 years, last year in July. And since then, many, many webinars are being held to make the public aware of what the policy is and to decide what the implementation should be. And we all know that the National Education Policy is a very, very forward-looking policy, very innovative policy, very student-centric policy. But the crux lies in the implementation of the policy in letter and spirit. Therefore, AIU took it upon itself to make an implementation strategy for the National Education Policy 2020. And for this, we have the national conference, which we hold every year. Every year, AIU holds one national conference of vice chancellors and five zonal conference of vice chancellors. So the National Conference of Vice Chancellors, the theme will be implementation strategy for NEP 2020. And we propose to bring out a very good document indicating that what will be the implementation strategy of NEP, giving the for each recommendation of NEP, what type of action will be required, who will be the actor who will be taking that action, what will be the timelines within which that action should be taken, and also the performance indicator to see whether that action has been rightly taken or not, and to what extent. So for formulating that document, we have teamed up with Jindal Global University, and we are preparing that document. And as a run-up to that theme, we are holding 5 zonal conferences on various aspects of national education policy. These include, like in the, this is the 4th conference, the North Zone Conference. Before this, we had held East Zone, West Zone, and Central Zone Conference, and the last will be South Zone Conference. In the East Zone, we discussed equity and access. In the West Zone, we discussed reimagining teacher education, vocational education, and professional education. In Central Zone, we discussed promoting quality research and internationalization. And today we are discussing holistic and multidisciplinary education with technology integration. And the last one, which will be in South Zone on 24th and 25th of February, we'll be talking about governance and financing of higher education. Now, because of this COVID, normally our conferences are held face-to-face and they are very sought-after events. But this time, because of COVID, we had to hold all the conferences in the virtual mode. But we are very much hoping and we are keeping our fingers crossed to hold the national conference face-to-face, which will be in Ahmedabad, in Baba Saheb Ambedkar Open University, Ahmedabad, and most probably from 23rd to 25th of March. AIU, as you all know, is an association with some more than 800 universities as its members. And we are doing a lot of activities in the field of academics, research, youth affairs, sports, and also the equivalence of foreign degrees with the Indian degrees. So the mandate of equating the foreign degrees with the Indian degrees has been given to AIU. And during this COVID, when everybody was thinking that the universities and colleges are closed, students are sitting at home, teachers are sitting at home, so life will come to a standstill in the higher education sector. AIU was on its toes and we were trying our best to reach out to the universities, colleges, teachers, students. So what we did was that we held many, many online courses for the teachers on telling them how to teach online, because teaching online was something which our teachers were not very, very aware of. But I must appreciate and compliment that our teachers very easily took over to online teaching. But we did hold many, many conferences, online workshops on teaching them how to teach online. We held workshops for placement officers for online placements and internships. We digitized our university news, which is a very sought after document. So this was digitized and e-copy was available on the AIU website. So we didn't stop any of the activities of AIU during the COVID, rather we became more active. So we also held scholarly articles were released every week. And then the various platforms, the working platforms, the online platforms on which the teaching is done. So training on those platforms was also given. There were many, many roundtables of vice chancellor, and we brought up very good publications. One was India Higher Education Profile. That is with all the universities. We brought out a book on reimagining Indian universities. We brought out a COVID-19 response toolkit, which gave a step-by-step guide on how to reopen the institutions after COVID. Now most of the institutions are opening. So that toolkit is there. That is around 100 pages toolkit, which gives a step-by-step guide on how to reopen the institutions while maintaining social distancing and what type of academic research and administrative steps should be taken while reopening the institutions. We also did a survey on preparedness of Indian higher education institutions for online education, because there is an issue of digital divide. So we did an online survey on how prepared our educational institutions are for online education. The report will very soon be with you. In youth affairs, we did have many, many programs on youth affairs, but one was which was done virtually, which we named as Kuch Artistic Corona. Corona was rhyming with Corona. So in that, we asked for video performances of the students, and the first, second, third prizes were given. And there was an overwhelming response with about 2,500 entries from 600 higher education institutions. In sports, we held the first Khelo India University Games in Orissa, and it was inaugurated by Honorable Prime Minister of India. And most of the work has been computerized in AIU. For example, equivalence of degrees, which I was talking about. The equivalence is, you can apply online and you can download the equivalence certificate online. There is no need to visit UGC or even send an offline application. So all applications are sent online. So these are the type of activities which we are doing. Right now, VC seniority, for the participating vice chancellors, the VC seniority list is being updated on the AIU website. So please upload your seniority, because that is required by us to nominate people on the governing council, means nominating esteemed vice chancellors on the governing council, and also for deciding that who will be the future presidents and vice presidents of AIU. So please fill in your seniority on the AIU portal. and internationalization also we have been doing a lot of work. Now coming to the theme of the conference, holistic and multidisciplinary education with technology integration. Now when we talk of multidisciplinary education, the national education policy does say that every institution should be multidisciplinary so that holistic education can be imparted to the students. But the question is, what is the definition of multidisciplinary? Will the government define what is multidisciplinary means? Will it mean one faculty, two faculty, three faculty, or more faculties? How many disciplines will constitute multidisciplinary? Because every institution cannot have all the disciplines. It has to be a certain set of disciplines which can be there. So there has to be a proper definition that with how many disciplines we will be treated as multidisciplinary institutions. And once that is done, then the universities have to think that depending upon their student profile, their teacher profile, their locational profile, what type of industries are around the university, that what type of disciplines they have to have. Similarly, when we shift from 3-year to 4-year bachelor's degree, so curriculum designing, what type of curriculum should be there? And when we talk of multiple entry and exit, then obviously the universities have to amend their ordinances to allow multiple entry and exit. But at the same time, when the curriculum is being transacted and where multiple entry and multiple exit is allowed, the universities have to see that the curriculum for every year is a capsule in itself, complete in itself. So that when the student goes out, he or she is having the complete knowledge of at least that year, once you give a certificate or diploma or degree after first, second or third year. So all these things have to be done, and then we have to create optimal learning environment for the students. We have to, I mean, the policy clearly says that we have to shift from rote learning to a learning where the curiosity is sort of aroused in the students, where creative thinking is there, where critical thinking is there, where problem solving techniques are there, where sort of application oriented study is there. So for this, we do have to shift from the traditional classroom teaching model to flipped classroom model approach so that the understanding of the students is better. The policy also talks about the faculty development in terms of capacity building of the faculty. The policy does say that the teachers will be trained not only for online teaching, not only for say use of technology for teaching learning, but also for leadership quality. And if the vice chancellor sees that any teacher has leadership quality or leadership acumen, the teacher will be trained for leadership enhancement so that he or she can be groomed to become a future vice chancellor or a future registrar. So all these things are there. Similarly, when you talk of technology integration, we all know that the COVID-19 has told us about the new normal, that the online teaching can also be done. And when the studies resume back, I mean, after COVID, in face-to-face manner, I'm very sure that the future will neither be face-to-face nor online. It will be a blended mode of education in the new normal. Therefore, online is not going to go away. It is going to stay here forever. So all these issues will be discussed in the conference today, that what type of steps the university should be taking, how they will be bridging the digital divide, how they will be doing the capacity building of the teachers, how the way we teach will be decided, and how what we teach will be decided. So all will be deliberated in the conference today and tomorrow to formulate the implementation strategy document, which will be submitted to the Government of India at the time of the National Conference of AIU. My request to all the vice chancellors would be to deliberate at length on these issues and come out with critical recommendations which will help to ensure the implementation of NEP in letter and spirit. And we all know that the policy has the potential to make India a Vishwa Guru once again if it is implemented in letter and spirit, and the onus lies on the heads of our higher education institutions. With this, I would like to thank the Honorable Lieutenant Governor Shri Anil Bajalji once again for agreeing to grace the occasion and welcome all the Vice Chancellors to this meet. Thank you. Jai Hind. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Mittal, for your welcome speech and setting the tone for the conference. May I now request Honorable President AIU, Dr. Tej Pratap, to kindly deliver his presidential address.
Thank you, Namrata. I hope I am audible.
Yes, sir, you're audible. Fine,
thank you. Well, Honorable Lieutenant Governor Anil Bajalji, Mr. Rajeshwar Prasad, Principal Secretary of Higher Education, Government of Delhi, my own colleague, Dr. Mahesh Verma, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, the host of hosting the event today. My colleague, Dr. Thiru Vasagam, Vice President of Association of Indian Universities, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, the Secretary General, Dr. Dadich, Registrar of the University, all Vice Chancellor colleagues, Honorable Vice Chancellor of North Zone Universities who are online today. Namaste, good morning, and I appreciate sparing time to be on this online conference. Dear colleagues, as Dr. Mittal has explained that this is a very special year for us, that normally for North Zone, we would pick up topics of very different type, basically ideas, maybe theoretical, philosophical, but it was a very special year last year when Government of India announced a national education policy. I'm sure most of you have read the document, not only read, reread it time and again, and now you must be working within the universities about implementing it. Let me be very honest. This is my own group of Honorable Vice Chancellor. Writing a document and putting a strategy up front about the future is one thing that's been done, but thinking about implementation of this national education policy, it's a big challenge indeed. As a Vice Chancellor, I understand the kind of challenges all of us, I would, including me, are going to face, all universities will face. And then we thought in the Association of Indian Universities that probably the meetings of Vice Chancellors, East, West, North, South, it would be best thing that we select topics, give to them, and they share their ideas and experiences how to go about it. This is going to help us. It's not just only saying, but we will compile them and give you back whatever you have shared on these things. Dr. Mittal already explained that we picked up different issues within the national education policy. Many of them debated so far in three meetings, East, West, one. Now, the Northern Zone Vice Chancellors are given with the challenge of thinking about what is it holistic. It talks about holistic. To say is one thing, multidisciplinarity, and integration of technology. We already saw Corona helped us pushing the integration to online. That was something probably we would have been still debating, but that is there. It's now a new normal that we will continue to have online and offline education future. And that was already envisioned in this policy. So in a way, sometimes one has to say for bad things also. Thank you. Thanks, Corona. You helped us integrate online things. But let me come back to this whole issue of multidisciplinarity. It's easier said than done. I would say it, that the kind of universities we are, general universities, technical universities, agriculture universities, horticulture universities, and if there are subject-based universities going down to horticulture and veterinary sciences and fisheries, we have all those in our North Zone too. Now, what could it be, the meaning of multidisciplinarity? I myself leading the task force for agriculture universities. And it is really quite difficult to imagine how do we direct people to go multi, what would be the scale? Social sciences and arts together, only two disciplines, or the departments are considered disciplines? Agriculture universities with 5 colleges or 10 colleges, or do we mean that we take everything, say if there are agriculture universities from 5 colleges disciplines to 15, what could be the scale of that? And it is easy to say, okay, you can increase to 15, but then at the same time, what about finances? What about infrastructure? So based on these things, again, there are also areas where technology will play a role in reducing our burden. We have another kind of challenge, all of us Vice Chancellors, confronted with the financial stringency, scarcity. Now, can technology be used not only for teaching, but in governance? Can it reduce our human resources pressure, or it will increase? And this integration of technology in governance, in academics, in other areas is equally important. And in this whole arena, many of you have experimented these things. And this is the platform where I would appreciate that you share your experiences, because ideology and theory is one. We would capture your stories of challenges. You picked up the challenge, you experimented. What was your experience? What works, what does not work? Then let other colleagues not experiment the same thing. So this platform is intentionally designed to discuss different issues relating to national educational policy, so that we reduce the time of experimentation by each university, each one of us. And we benefit from others' experiences. We will also benefit from collective ideas when we put them together. Later in March, late March, we are going to meet in Ahmedabad, where we will then distill the ideas that you have floated here. We will present them there in different sessions, and there has to be a document coming out that helps us all. It should be something, a written kind of Bible for all of us that helps in implementation. All colleagues in different ways. This is exactly what I am also looking for in the next 2 days that you have. Please do not restrict yourself only to these things. Look, multidisciplinary, holistic technology integration in relation to the ideas, the topics that we have already discussed. It's equity, it is access, it is a lot of other things that you have seen. Those are there in national education policy. In relation to integration, in relation to this, that, and everything. And I'm sure with your experience and wisdom, the 2 days you are going to spend for debate, I expect a lot of very good ideas, very useful ideas, very productive, that will guide us in implementing the process. And end of the day, when you are in Ahmedabad, to say that would be our yardstick, a parameter. How are we feeling, comfortable or uncomfortable in implementing national education policy? That's exactly what we are expecting, that we will convey to Ministry of Human Resources Development. This is what the vice chancellors do feel about in implementing this one. And if there are any major issues, this is again the platform. List them, please, and we will raise them. When we put the collective voice together and then forward it, it will be heard, definitely. This is what I had to say about these next 2 days that you would be spending. Thank you very much. Thanks, my colleagues in IU and all of you vice chancellors who have been kind enough to spare the time to participate in this meeting. And finally, Anil Bajalji to really spare the time for addressing us in this inaugural session. Thank you, Namrata. Back to you.
Thank you very much, sir, for being absolutely topical by focusing on the challenges that the higher education sector in India faces and providing that direction for future growth of Indian higher education. Thank you so much once again. Next, we have lined up the release of University News of AIU. University News is a weekly journal of higher education brought out by the Association of Indian Universities. It is the only journal catering to Indian higher education system for the last 91 years. University News is popular for the richness of its content and clockwise regularity. Some of the unique features like the thesis of the month and convocation address make it essential and sought after for the academia. Dr. Sisla Rama Devi Pani has been editing the University News for the last 21 years. May I now request the Honorable Chief Guest of the function, Shri Anil Baijal, Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, to kindly release the University News. I may also request Professor Tej Pratap, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Professor Mahesh Verma, and Dr. S. Rama Devi Pani to also join the release. Thank you so much, Honorable Lieutenant Governor Delhi, for releasing the special university news. And thank you so much, others, for joining. I may now request Honorable Lieutenant Governor Delhi, Shri Anil Baijalji, to kindly address the gathering.
Dr. Tej Pratap, President Association of Indian Universities, Mr. Rajeshwar Prasad, am I audible?
Yes, please.
Yes, sir.
Very much.
Mr. Rajeshwar Prasad, Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General of the Association, Professor Mahesh Verma, Vice Chancellor of Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, Vice Chancellors of the Universities of North Zone of the country, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to be present in this Vice Chancellor's Conference, which is a part of series of zone-wise conferences to culminate in a national convention to discuss the implementation of issues of the new education policy, as has been mentioned by everybody who has spoken before me. The theme of this conference is holistic and multidisciplinary education with technology integration. In the current era of global integration, not only the economies of the nations, but a parallel integration in the field of education is also occurring. The modern levels of education worldwide are coming together to define a global vision of education and research. NEP is a major step in this direction in the country. Needless to say, to achieve a global standing in the field of education, Indian universities have to leverage technology in the field of education and research. Technology ushers in fundamental structural changes that can be integral to achieving significant improvements in productivity. Useful for both teaching and learning, technology infuses classrooms with digital learning tools, be it computers and handheld devices, expands course offerings, experiences, and learning materials, supports learning 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Technology also has the power to transform teaching by ushering in a new model of connected teaching, which links teachers to their students, to professional content, resources, and systems to help them improve the content and quality of education. Thus, in this technology-driven world, implementation of NEP offers an opportunity to introspect and think about what might provide impetus to the growth of a university and its contribution for promoting higher education. But to begin with, there is the fundamental question: what is the purpose of education? Should one be educated to get prepared to enter the workforce? Or should the purpose of education be focused more on social, academic, cultural, and intellectual development so that one could grow up to be an engaged citizen? Let me submit with some hesitation in this August gathering that for me, it doesn't have to be either or. Education should prepare the youth for life, work, and good, responsible citizenship. Knowledge of the natural and engineering environments and how people live in the world is critical to all three purposes of education. Critical thinking, creativity, interpersonal skills, and a sense of social responsibility all influence success in life, work, and citizenship. For example, an unhappy personal relationship often spills over into the work environment, while a stressful workplace or unemployment and negativity affects the family life. Uninformed, disengaged citizens lead to poor policy choices that impact life, work, and citizenship. University management and policy makers should therefore design policies and programs which can promote education for life, work, and citizenship. I would like to touch upon an altogether new initiative for consideration of the university management. We all know universities do not exist in a vacuum. Indeed, every university is at the heart of its local community, and as such has a duty to contribute to that community by supporting business activity, particularly at a small scale. We all know that a large chunk of the youth of this country would have to be employed by MSMEs. These small units are generally owned by one or two untrained first generation entrepreneurs who have to handle all tasks by themselves, from setting up the unit to sourcing raw material, business promotion, managing logistics to administration and marketing of products. This MSME segment, to be successful requires handholding. There's an emergent need to promote the spirit of entrepreneurship among the promoters of these small enterprises. While at the level of its people, India would rank high on the increasing number of entrepreneurs, at the institutional level, where friendly ecosystems need to be laid for encouraging entrepreneurship, we have a long way to go. Universities could play a critical role in incubating the spirit of entrepreneurship.
It seems there is some kind of a technical issue from the Honorable Lieutenant Governor's side. So we'll wait for him to join us back here. So I guess you are on mute. So I would kindly request you to unmute yourself.
Unmute myself. Yes.
Thank you so much, sir.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Thank you.
Did I become inaudible in between or what?
Yes, sir. There was some technical issue from your end, but you are perfectly audible now.
Okay. So, I don't know where did I get inaudible. But anyway, if you like, I don't know where. I wish you had told me earlier. I would have unmuted myself earlier as well.
If you want, I can help. You were talking about the responsibility of the universities.
Sorry?
You were talking about the responsibility of the universities to help the youth to get into MSMEs. That's what you were talking about.
Okay, then I think it must be the last part. As MSMEs, I said that the time has come and university needs to redefine their relationship with the corporate sector and tap the enormous potential available with corporates after mandatory CSR obligations under the company law, which includes funding research activities. The more your research activities are planned, around theme would effectively capture the technological changes in the industry and make timely changes in the course curriculum to bridge the knowledge and skill gap between the industry requirements and those imparted to the students, and thus enhancing the employability of graduating students. Friends, as I close, I wish to remind you that educational system isn't really worth a great deal if it teaches young people how to make a living alone without teaching them how to make a life. So vice chancellors and universities can lead the institutions to achieve academic excellence. I hope that you will have fruitful discussions during this conference that will lead to new paradigm of education that will take your institution to great heights. Thank you all once again for having given me this opportunity to be amongst you all today. I wish this conference all success, and I would keenly look forward to receiving your recommendations. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. On behalf of AIU and Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, it is my honor to thank you for gracing this occasion and supporting the endeavors of AIU in placing India on the global platform of knowledge and wisdom. We are immensely grateful for your benevolent presence and your inspirational words. Thank you so much for joining us here. May I now request Shri Ravi Dadhich, Registrar, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, to kindly deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Namrata. As the Registrar of IP University, I convey my sincere gratitude and regards to Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi and Chancellor of the IP University, Shri Anil Bajal Ji, sir. Honorable Chancellor of various universities from North India, Shri H. Rajesh Prasad Ji, Principal Secretary, Higher Education, Government of NCT of Delhi, officers from AIU and GGSIP University, directors, deans, professors, and all the distinguished dignitaries for sparing their valuable time to grace the inaugural ceremony of the North Zone Vice Chancellor's Meet of Association of Indian Universities, hosted by IP University for the first time. I convey my heartfelt thanks to Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, Shri Anil Bajal Ji, for sharing his noble thoughts and vision on the core theme of this meet, which is in sync with the National Education Policy 2020, a policy with progressive outlook and having an objective to bring Indian education system at par with global education system, and particularly the emphasis laid by Sir to encourage entrepreneurship with the help of CSR and employability for the youth, and to prepare the youth for the life as the purpose of the education. I also extend my sincere thanks to the Association of Indian Universities President Dr. Tej Pratap Singh Ji for delivering the presidential address, and Dr. Pankaj Mittal, Secretary General, for her inaugural address to tell us about the implementation strategy and timelines and performance indicators for the NEP 2020. The words of wisdom shared by them would go a long way towards the speedy implementation of the objective of achieving the holistic and multidisciplinary education, both at the undergraduate and postgraduate levels across all the universities. Events like this require extensive planning, and I am privileged to extend sincere thanks and also mention that we have been fortunate enough to have a team led by our Vice Chancellor, Professor Mahesh Varmaji, for being a catalyst to do our best, and he always stands as a pillar of strength for us. With a deep sense of appreciation, I thank all the officers and officials of IP University and AIU for their dedicated and untiring efforts to make this conference successful, and also to all the participants for attending the inaugural session. Finally, I wish you on the eve of Basant Panchami, the festival of Goddess Saraswati, and also the arrival of spring season. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir, for delivering the vote of thanks. May I now request all the distinguished guests and delegates to kindly on their cameras for a photo op. I request everybody to kindly on their cameras. Thank you so much, everyone. We hereby conclude this auspicious inaugural ceremony with Jana Gana Mana. May I humbly request everyone to rise for the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे